What does Joseph Haydn's oratorio The Creation and Hegel's philosophy have in common? And what does dialectics have to do with it all? Let's find out. Joseph Haydn's The Creation is generally regarded as one of the most important masterpieces of the classical period. It is mostly based on the poem Paradise Lost by John Milton, who is seen as an early proponent of the Enlightenment, a philosophical, political and cultural movement advocating ideals such as tolerance, liberty and progress. Another person usually being associated with the Enlightenment is Georg Wilhelm Friedrich Hegel. Hegel was a German philosopher who wrote a lot of very complicated things bordering incomprehensibility. One of his major contributions to philosophy is redefining the concept of dialectics. While the ancient Greeks thought of dialectics as a fancy way of having a discussion, Hegel takes a metaphysical approach. Hegel starts with an abstract idea, which then is negated. Through this process, the abstract is turned into the concrete. In his book Science of Logic, Hegel uses the metaphor of pure light and pure darkness to explain his concept of dialectics. Pure light and pure darkness are two voids which are the same thing. Light is determined by darkness, and so is darkened light, and darkness is determined by light, is illuminated darkness. And for this reason, that it is only darkened light and illuminated darkness which have within themselves the moment of difference and are, therefore, determinate being. We can find an allusion to this idea in the beginning of Haydn's Creation. The oratorio starts with a quote from the book of Genesis. God created the heaven and the earth was without form and void. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, Let there be light, and there was light. And God saw the light, that it was good, and God divided the light from the darkness. This seems like a good short summary of Hegelian dialectics. In the beginning there was pure darkness, which would be the abstract, then God created pure light, which would be the negative, which he then in a third step divided from darkness, turning the abstract into the concrete.
When we look only at the musical material, we have to notice that Haydn actually isn't really accentuating this metaphysical aspect. His musical rendering is rather a naive depiction. But towards the end of the oratorio, there's actually an example where Haydn uses actual musical means to express an idea similar to that of Hegel's dialectics.
This aria, the final phase in God's creation, is being recounted. After God has created all animals and even humans, one thing, arguably the most important thing, is missing: death. According to Hegel, the popular proverbs that all that exists has the germ of death in its very birth, that death, on the other hand, is the entrance into new life, expressed at bottom the union of being and nothing. The first verse of this aria is about life. God is feeding the animals which he has created. Haydn uses solely woodwinds in this part. Woodwinds are a group of instruments consisting of flutes, oboes, clarinets, and bassoons. The second verse of this aria is about death. God takes the animal's breath away and they vanish into dust. Haydn uses solely strings in this part. Strings are a group of instruments consisting of violins, violas, violoncellos, and basses. In the third verse, God revives the animals. Thus, the circle of life and death is established. In this part, Haydn uses woodwinds and strings combined to signify the dialectical union of life and death. Hegel writes, pure being and pure nothing are, therefore, the same. What is the truth is neither being nor nothing, but that being has passed over into nothing and nothing into being. But it is equally true that they are not undistinguished from each other, that, on the contrary, they are not the same, that they are absolutely distinct, and yet that they are unseparated and inseparable, and that each immediately vanishes in its opposite. Their truth is therefore this movement of the immediate vanishing of the one into the other, becoming a movement in which both are distinguished, but by a difference which has equally immediately resolved itself.
Admittingly, this is a rather superficial interpretation of Haydn's music as well as Hegel's philosophy, but I think this is a good way to get insight into a lot of ideas and concepts of the Enlightenment. I don't know, what do you think? Leave a comment. As always, please like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. Huge thank you to Daniel Gianocano, who's supporting me on Patreon. If you want to get exclusive behind the scenes footage or just want to support me, feel free to check out my Patreon account. Thank you for watching.